While some controversy is brewing over the November ballot, the lawsuit has been filed against the City of Memphis and Shelby County Election Commission over the wording on the ballot.
Save IRV, which stands for Instant Runoff Voting, Memphis, and several other groups are asking for the ballot to be rewritten as it could confuse voters. Now, a judge did say the ballot is written correctly. University of Memphis Professor Steve Mulroy is also Assistant Dean of the Law School, and Reverend Regina Clarke with First Abyssinian Baptist Church join us. So break this down for us in layman's language, Steve, if you can.
Sure.
What's the issue? And when the court ruled against the lawsuit, what does that mean?
Right. And so if I could be very clear on it, the court didn't say that the ballot was okay. The court didn't reach the merits. The court said instead that we filed too early,
okay,
that the proper thing to
do
would be...
So it was a technical issue.
Yeah, to wait until after the election and see the results of the election. And then if we were displeased, then we could always challenge it at that time.
Doesn't that seem backwards
It seems backwards to me, but that was what the court said. So we haven't really gotten a ruling on the merits of our argument, which is that the ballot language is too misleading. The first one says, let's go to 3-term limits without telling voters that there already are 2-term limits.
Meaning 3 terms and you're out.
Correct.
Instead, right now it's 2, okay.
Correct. So currently it would be 8 years because we already voted on that. The city council is trying to get it extended to 12 years.
Okay.
But it doesn't tell you that. It doesn't tell you what the current is.
So they just assume you know.
Correct.
Okay.
Then the second one says, let's get rid of instant runoff voting, which allows you to rank your first, second, and third choices so you don't have to go back to the polls for a runoff election.
Right, council members don't like that.
No, they don't like that because it makes elections more competitive. But the state law says that it's supposed to tell you on the face of the ballot whether it'll cost money or save money. Last time, when we originally voted for instant runoff voting, the ballot certified that instant runoff voting would save $250,000 a year.
Because you wouldn't have to have the runoff election?
Correct. And now that they're trying to repeal that before we've even had a chance to try instant runoffs once, the ballot should say that doing that would cost $250,000 a year, but it doesn't do that. So we think that's misleading. And then third and finally, the third referendum would repeal instant runoff voting also, but in a way directly contradictory of the second way. So we say that that's fatally confusing.
What do you mean? Because I'm confused.
Yeah, well.
I need a translator to come with me to the polling site and translate everything for me.
Precisely our point. Yeah. Precisely our point. It's so confusing, and I think it's by design. They're trying to trick people into voting yes when they might otherwise want to vote against the amendments. So what I mean to say is the Second Amendment says, let's repeal instant runoff voting by going back to the old-fashioned system of having a second runoff election, even though no one shows up and even though they're expensive. The third one says, let's repeal instant runoff voting by getting rid of all runoff elections and letting someone win with 20-25% of the vote.
So that's the third,
Charter amendment, referendum.
Yeah,
charter. Yes.
That's the third referendum, and if we vote for that, that would essentially do that.
Yes.
Someone could win
with 20-25% of the vote. So if, let's say, to take one example, if you had a black majority district and too many black candidates ran, then a white candidate might win with 25% of the vote because the vote was split, even though that candidate may not be the preferred person of a majority of the voters.
Gotcha.
And I'm not trying to racialize this. Take Republicans. Too many Republicans split the Republican vote in
right.
a Republican majority.
So a Democrat may represent the district, which really doesn't represent.
Correct.
So what is our next step? What are folks supposed to do? How should they arm the information when they're going to the polls? I mean, it's going to happen no matter what. And some of the ballots have already been sent out. So how are we going to change anything?
So what we need to do is, it's all about education. And that's what we're trying to do, is educate the voters. Because what basically happened is, in 2008, 70% of the voters already said what they wanted out of this, and they want to have instant runoff voting. They've already put in the term limits. Basically, what they're saying now is, you didn't really know what you were talking about. Trust us, we know what's best for you, so let's do this again. So it is important that we talk to everyone about it. I spoke to some seniors recently on Saturday who were confused.
Did they understand?
They did not understand what was happening. And so once we sat out and talked about it, then they were able to understand that the wording is flawed and the wording is set up so that it will be confusing.
So the Election Commission, which designs this, is supposed to be a bipartisan nonpartisan body.
The City Council actually wrote the language.
Is that normal?
The Election Commission's taken the position that they will just print whatever the City Council sends them. It's not their job to micromanage. It's up to the City Council to write the referendum.
But it is their job to monitor the elections, so it would seem to me that they're the ones who should be writing this.
Perhaps. You know, our position is, it doesn't matter whether it's the city council or the election commission, all we know is that the language on the ballot is confusing and misleading, and the voters are being tricked. And one other thing we should probably mention, just found out yesterday, the sample ballots that the election commission had been putting out talked about voting yes or no. All our literature is talking about voting no. We found out yesterday that the actual ballot says for or against. And that actually has added additional confusion on top of all the other confusion.
Wow. Okay, so we're in an early voting period. So basically, is there a website where people can go and read what? Get some clarification.
Yes, we're urging people to go to www.saveirvmemphis.com, where we have the information about.
And you're
the
not evidence. Advocating a position. You're just saying here's the information.
Means.
There's also information from the League of Women Voters that spells it out in plain English language on what we're voting on.
What a bring that with you to the
plain English.
Plain English.
Now, the League of Women Voters is a good resource. I mean, we are urging voters to vote against the amendments for all the reasons we said. But if you go to the website and you look at the League of Women Voters information, that is a neutral statement of that.
Right. Okay.